Hey, what's up, YouTube? Model community. Chucky Monster here. I'm just giving you an update on the 62 Corvette and the 38 Ford van that I'm doing, the custom van that I'm doing. I haven't really got too far. I'm pretty much doing all the sanding and all the cleaning up of both kits right now, so I just got this done the other day, the body of this, and let me see if I can show you the body of the gasser. I kind of just got the sanding, and I got it all primered. I use Dupli-Color primer. Their products are good. I don't really care for the clear much. So I do a two-stage urethane clear. I airbrush a lot, but I do like to spray Dupli-Color here and there. And I am gonna spray Dupli-Color on this. I've got a color all picked out and that I really wanted to do on here, and it's been in my paint collection for a little while. You can see that. I don't know if you can see that. See, it did have really bad mold lines all the way through here. A lot of flash on this kit. There's a piece of lint on there, but it's not in there. I mean, I got this body mint. It was a mess, man, when I started it. It had mold lines and flash everywhere on this kit. I mean, it was horrible. But it did come out actually perfect. So I'm looking forward to getting paint on this thing. That's what I like to do. I like to paint. I mean, I even took off the Corvette emblems on here because I don't like them when they're raised. I took the Corvette emblem off of here. So I might clear over the decals on here. I don't like the raised emblems on my models. I'd rather have a decal set and clear or photo etched. That's just how I am, but everybody builds their way. Everybody likes to see what they like to see on their models, but so really that came out pretty good. I primered a bunch of stuff today. I don't know if I want to shoot the paint on here just yet because my airbrush or my paint booth is taking a crap, so I'm thinking about building another one. It works sometimes, it doesn't work sometimes, so I'm thinking about building another one, and then I can build it to my dimension, put lights in it, and get the right ventilation. You know, I have one of them plastic ones, so I don't know if you can see, but it's right there. You can pretty much see what I use now, so it's one of those type of deals. So, and they serve their purpose. A lot of people use them. They usually last me about 2 to 3 years, maybe. So I think 3 years being tops. The last one I had, all the plastic got brittle, but I was cleaning it with stuff I shouldn't have been cleaning it with. So, you know, and now I put paper, or I cut some construction paper and put it in there now before I paint. So, and I use it for a little while and then I change it out. So I figure I'll do that when I build my other box too. But all right, with that being said, so if anybody has any ideas on building one, leave me a comment, leave me something, you know, maybe I can a link to something, maybe I'll watch something and build something like maybe somebody else built or something. Maybe it'll help me out. Maybe I want to do it out of wood and put some lights in it, and, you know, I want it nice. But so if anybody's got any ideas, let me know. But I did pick up some models. I went to Hobby Lobby, and I haven't been there in a long time, and I picked up the kit a lot of people are talking about the Grease Lightning. I haven't opened it yet. Maybe I'll do a box review on it. I'm looking forward to building this. I know they're going to have another one coming out with a variation of the red one in this. So I'm looking forward to that. So I probably won't even open it until then. What else did I get? I got the 67 GTX, which I'm looking forward to popping this open too. I haven't opened any of these. I'm kind of trying to keep them in plastic, so maybe I'll start doing some kit reviews for everybody else. I did get the El Camino, the Gear Hustler AMT. I am looking forward to building this again. I built it once already, back when I first got back into models, but I got some plans for this. I really like this year. I also picked up, I went to Andy's Hobby Headquarters, and I picked up a couple models there, and I haven't popped those open either, but I haven't seen that in a while, and I thought that'd be kind of neat to put my twist on that. I've got one of these already, but I just picked it up anyway for $20, you know. I'm looking forward to doing that also, so. And I went to the antique store, and I've seen these and up here and there and that online, and I've been wanting to build one of these. There you go, the Dino Ferrari. I think I can really do this. I hope I can, you know, do some justice on this, but that's what's been going down here. So I mean, pretty much either shopping, buying stuff that I have way too many already. I've been doing a lot of sanding and primering, and I've been stripping chrome. So I'm stripping the chrome off this bed. I didn't like the kit chrome, and some pieces are okay, but I think I'm gonna strip it and do it all myself in all clad or something. The chrome looked fake, so now I get to sand all this and get this in primer, and then I'll start shooting paint on stuff. So yeah, my battery says it's going dead. So anyway, I just thought I'd put up a video so everybody knows I'm still out there, and I am working on these things. It's just I'm doing it slowly because of the grandkid. So I hope you guys all have a good holiday. Maybe I'll be able to post a video this weekend. I'm off for a few days, so hopefully I get some color on that. So, and if I do, I will shoot a vid for you guys. So everyone take care, have a good Thanksgiving, have a safe Thanksgiving, no drinking, no driving, you know, get a designated driver if you guys drink. Be safe out there, guys, and happy holidays. Bye.